Good morning, students. Now we have come to the next part of the structure of mitochondria. We have discussed about the outer inner membrane. The inner membrane, we have come now. The inner membrane gives rise to finger-like projections. Just now I have shown in the diagram also finger-like projections. These are called the cristae. Cristae. C-R-I-S-T-A-E. Cristae. These cristae increase the inner surface area. Whenever folding will be there, surface area will be increased. What is understood of the mitochondria to hold variety of enzymes. Now oxisomes, fourth part. The inner mitochondrial membrane bear minute, regularly spaced, tennis racket shaped particles. They are called oxisomes. So I will show on this. This is the cristae on which the racket shaped structure. This is one stalk will be there, on that one rounded or swollen structure is there. These are called the oxisomes. Oxisomes, or they are also called the F1 particle. F1 particle. So racket shaped, tennis racket shaped structures, these are called the oxisomes, or they are also called the F1 particles. They involve in ATP synthesis. Now if we show the diagram, this is, these F1 particles are having the three parts. What are the three parts are there? No, they are having the stalk and the base. Base is not marked here, you should be mark also base. Base, stalk and the bulbar structure, which is called the F1. And their main function is to perform the synthesis of ATP. Now mitochondrial matrix. Mitochondrial matrix, it is a complex mixture of proteins and lipids. Matrix is nothing but the jelly-like substance which is present to the inside of the inner membrane. Mitochondrial matrix contains enzymes for Krebs cycle, mitochondrial ribosomes, 70S type tRNAs and mitochondrial DNA. All these are present in mitochondrial matrix. Now what are the functions of mitochondria? First function, mitochondria is the main organelle of cell respiration. They produce a large amount of ATP molecules, so they are called the powerhouses of the cell. 2 marks question, why do mitochondria call powerhouse of the cell? Or it is also called ATP factory of the cell. Number two, it helps the cells to maintain normal concentration of calcium ions. It also regulates the metabolic activity of the cell. So 2 marks question, the function of mitochondria. Number two, next part we are going to discuss types of respiration. Respiration involves, we know, the exchange of, whenever definition will be coming, you will be saying the exchange of gases between the organism and the external environment. The plants obtain oxygen from the environment and release carbon dioxide and water vapor. This exchange of gases generally is called the external respiration. It is a physical process. Oxygen is getting inside, carbon dioxide is coming out. Physical process. But biochemical process occurs after getting oxygen inside the body. The oxygen is reaching to the cell, where the oxygen will be utilized to break down of food material. So actually oxygen is needed for the cell to break down the food material to release the energy. In that case it is called the cellular respiration, because inside the cell the oxygen is utilized. So biochemical process occurs within the cells, where the food is oxidized to obtain energy. This is known as cellular respiration. So actually respiration is happening in two steps: external respiration and cellular respiration. Now these respiration types we will be discussing. There are two types of respiration: aerobic respiration and the anaerobic respiration. But here main thing we'll be focusing on aerobic respiration. What do you mean by aerobic respiration? Is the type of cellular respiration in which organic food is completely oxidized with the help of oxygen into carbon dioxide, water and energy. It occurs in most plants and animals. What is the chemical formula? Now C6H12O6 plus 6O2 in by impressions of oxygen food material. This is the food material oxidized and it forms carbon dioxide, water and ATP, which is called the energy. What are the stages? There are three stages in aerobic respiration. First stage is called the glycolysis. Second stage is called the Krebs. Third stage is called the ETC. In short, you can keep in your memory ETC, electron transport chain. Now one by one, three things we'll be discussing. What is the meaning of this glycolysis? Where does it take place in the cell? And what are the products are produced? Glycolysis, what is the meaning? Glyco, glucose. Lysis means breakdown or splitting. So glucose breakdown takes place, breakdown of one molecule of glucose into two and produce two molecules of pyruvic acid. So glucose breaking into pyruvic acid, that is happening in glycolysis. One molecule glucose is producing two molecules pyruvic acid. Where does it take place? Now glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm of the cell. That is very, very important. One more question. It is the first step of both. This step is common for both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Number two, Krebs cycle. This cycle occurs in mitochondrial matrix. At the end of glycolysis, what are the products? Now two molecules of pyruvic acid. Two molecules of pyruvic acid enter into the mitochondrial matrix. The oxidation of pyruvic acid takes place and produce CO2 and water through this cycle. This cycle is also called the TCA cycle. TCA, what is the full form? T for tri, C for carboxylic, A for acid. Tricarboxylic acid cycle. Third step, it is called the electron transport chain, ETC. It is accomplished or it is completed through a system of electron carriers complex called the ETC. That's why I told in the beginning itself. Located in the inner membrane of the mitochondria, that means on this F1 particle. NADH to FADH2 molecules formed during glycolysis and Krebs. These are the products of glycolysis. Alternative products, glycolysis and Krebs cycle, are oxidized. Oxidized means H2O will be left. This is reduced. Whenever hydrogen will be added, it is called reduced form. Whenever without hydrogen, it is called the oxidized form. So these products of NADH to FADH2, which are producing during glycolysis and Krebs cycle, will be oxidized in this stage and then form NAD plus and FAD plus, to release the energy via electrons. These electrons, as they move through the electron carrier system through a system of electron carriers, release energy which is trapped by ADP. ADP will be converted into ATP to synthesize ATP. This is called oxidative phosphorylation. The electrons, as they, from here, what do you mean by oxidative phosphorylation? The electrons, as they move through the system means electron carrier complex system, release energy which is trapped by ADP to synthesize ATP, which is called the oxidative phosphorylation. In this process, oxygen is the ultimate acceptor of electrons, and oxygen is reduced to form water. These are the three steps. Now next, second type of respiration, which is called the anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration takes place without oxygen. Anaerobic, an means absent, oxygen is absent. Glucose is converted into ethanol in plants and lactate in bacteria. So this is, here oxygen is not there, that is the difference in the chemical reaction. C6H12O6 plus oxygen, it was aerobic respiration, because aerobic respiration means when the food material will be broken down in presence of oxygen. But here anaerobic respiration, oxygen is absent, that's why we are not writing oxygen. Food material is there and it is producing 2CO2 plus ethyl alcohol and energy. That is the anaerobic, very small part. Now next part we are going to discuss, small but very, very important, respiratory quotient. Short form it is called RQ. R for respiratory, Q for quotient. Respiratory quotient is, what is the definition? The ratio or volume of carbon dioxide liberated, that means volume of carbon dioxide liberated and the volume of oxygen consumed. So how much volume of oxygen is consumed, that will be in down, and volume of carbon dioxide liberated, that will be on top. So volume of CO2 liberated will be divided by volume of oxygen consumed, which is called the RQ or respiratory quotient. So respiratory quotient is the ratio of volume of CO2 liberated and the volume of oxygen consumed during respiration. This one is also enough. So this is the end of this topic. Thank you, children.